this. This is the Bugatti Veyron Grand Sport. And you can see the beautiful cars are starting to make a comeback. This is a little on the pricey side at about $2.2 million per car. And Bugatti's very proud to sell 50 cars a year. You start to do the math on that, you wonder how they can survive. But the car is really quite extraordinary. Bugatti is a division of Volkswagen Group, and this is their signature car. I have to say, I work with Bugatti, and I know them there very, very well. I don't know if Ettore Bugatti would be happy with the car that's out there today, although it has some of the design themes of the original car, although it is a very much an aspirational car, like any Bugatti was in its day. It doesn't seem to follow the design tenets that Bugatti set down. Bugatti cars were lightweight, simple, and elegant. And Bugatti himself had no real engineering background. Everything he did, he learned on the job, and he had this innate feel for everything he did. And he would look at something and say, that looks right. And he was right most of the time. So his cars were very, very special. And the car today isn't simple. I mean, the car that I showed you has somewhere, I think it's the 1,200 horsepower version. They had one at 1,000 horsepower, but they felt it wasn't enough power. So they took it up to 1,200 horsepower. What's interesting about that car, it's a bit of a problem. If you drive it at top speed, after 16 minutes, your wheels, your tires will disintegrate. Top speed is 260-some miles an hour. But you don't really have to worry about that because you run out of gas at 8 miles. Or 8 minutes, I guess, you run out of gas. So you never really have to worry about blowing your tires to come. But this is all so contrary to what Ettore Bugatti would have done.